Everybody, welcome to this Fertility Friday again with me, Dr. Jacqueline. I am from In Vitality Wellness Center, the Wellness Way affiliate here in the South Denver area. So super excited to be coming to you guys. We're going to start doing our Fertility Fridays a little bit earlier. So we're going to start doing them at 1 p.m. Mountain Standard Time. That way I have access to the TV. And we can talk about some real cool things in detail. So for those of you that don't know me, I am super excited to be coming to you guys. I'm super passionate about hormones, but we definitely tackle all types of health issues. So today we're gonna really get into how our hormones are made. And it's really important, obviously, if you're having any type of fertility or hormone issues, to understand first off how they're made. So we're going to dive into that a little bit more in detail today, and I hope you guys learned something. So we got a couple people popping on today. Hey, Joanne, and I see a couple more people popping on here. So super excited to be with you guys today. If you guys have any questions as I go through this information, just comment below. If you know somebody that needs to understand this or is struggling with this information, just share this video with them. It's super easy to do. Just comment, like, and share below, and I'd be happy to chat with them as well if they're struggling with something. So we're going to kick off right into it, you guys. How are hormones made? So super important to understand, obviously, our hormone chart. So this is the pathway, and hopefully you guys can see that okay. I made it as big as I could. And this is a simplified chart. This isn't even with all the different cofactors and subdividing and all that fun stuff. But basically, how hormones are made, it all starts up here with this guy, cholesterol, if you guys can't see it. So cholesterol is this guy right here. So for all my ladies out there that are like fat phobic, please do not be fat phobic. It's super important to understand what types of healthy fats are out there. But cholesterol, you can see this triggers this whole cascade of how hormones are made. So obviously, if you're not getting enough fat intake and you don't have enough healthy fats, do you think you can make all this stuff? Absolutely not. So all these people that are like, oh, I'm so happy, you know, my cholesterol is under 150, blah, blah, blah. Well, that's really not necessarily the greatest level depending on your body. It's really, really important to understand that cholesterol is what triggers all these hormones to be made. So those ladies that are, you know, rocking that six pack, they could be extremely unhealthy because their fat deposits and their fat storage is so low in their body, and they're probably really watching their fat intake as well. So I always tell patients, you know, sometimes the most fit people are actually the most sick because they have literally just drained their body of the normal things. You also, through your fat deposits, that's another place your body will draw on to make hormones because, again, cholesterol is this big hormone maker. So it's really, really important to understand, first off, how hormones are made, especially if you're lacking in them or you're imbalanced in them. And then to understand, too, dietarily, what you guys can do naturally to really pump up this stuff. So it looks like we got a couple more people popping on. Hey, Nina. Hey, Tyler. Hey, Dr. Ashlyn. So super excited that you guys are joining us for this Fertility Friday. So again, how are hormones made? So it all starts up here with cholesterol. So obviously, if you don't have enough cholesterol, enough healthy fat in the body, we're not going to be able to make what we need. Cholesterol, you guys, is super good. It's found in things like avocados. If you don't have it on your food allergy list, it's super high in chicken eggs. And I always tell patients there's tons of other healthy fats out there. So things like raw, unprocessed cacao. So raw chocolate products, especially raw cacao butter, that has a lot of healthy fats in it. We absolutely love things like avocado oil, coconut oil, specifically MCT oil. That's a real concentrated form of coconut oil. Lots of seeds and nuts are really high in healthy fats and are good for your body. And olive oil is another great one that you guys can do dietarily, again, to pump up this cholesterol in a healthy manner. And we just don't want to heat up the olive oil. So anytime you guys are cooking with olive oil, you actually create rancid olive oil. So you do not want to heat coconut oil, or excuse me, olive oil. So olive oil is not an oil you want to cook with. You don't want to heat it up. It's not good for the body because it actually goes rancid and you spoil its natural state. It's not meant to be heated. So if you're going to heat up an oil, coconut oil is fantastic. Avocado oil, grapeseed oil, those are all great oils to cook with at a higher temperature. If it's not on your food allergy list, 100% grass-fed butter. We love Kerrygold butter at our house because it's made from 100% grass-fed cows that aren't treated with any types of hormones, that aren't treated with any types of steroids. So the Kerrygold butter is fantastic if cow's milk and dairy aren't part of your food allergy list. Another one that's great that if you can't do butter from cows is ghee. So 100% grass-fed ghee, it's easy to find out there. And that can be found easily at any type of supermarket. And so what they do is it's clarified butter, so all the milk proteins are taken out. So if you do have butter and cow's milk on your food allergy list, you can still do ghee. It's a fantastic way to get those healthy fats into the diet. So let's go through this cascade. I'm not going to go super detailed in it today. We're just going to get a little bit into it so you guys understand kind of how all these processes happen and how all your different hormones are made. So the first big mother hormone is called pregnenolone. So pregnenolone is how all your hormones start to happen, whether you're male or female. So from cholesterol, that gets converted into pregnenolone, and then we start two big different cascades. So this guy starts your progesterone cascade. And I've talked about progesterone several times before. So progesterone, for all the ladies out there, is extremely important to regulate your cycle. And it's important in the first 12 to 14 weeks of your pregnancy as well. So obviously this is a huge pathway. There's several derivatives, and we'll go over those. The other big cascade that starts to happen is into your androgen hormones. So into your DHEA, and then further down into the testosterone. So whether you're male or female, that's kind of the cascade that happens. And then the next section of it is from the testosterone, and a derivative of the DHEA comes our estrogens. So we've got E1, E2, E3. A lot of people don't realize estrogen is not just one type of hormone. So that's a big differential there, you guys. Estrogens are actually a group of hormones. So if you haven't had your estrogen tested properly, which most people haven't had done, there are a lot of different pieces and a lot of different metabolites to your estrogen cycle. So E1 is estrone, E2 is estradiol, and E3 is estriol. And those are your three big estrogens, but there's also ones beyond that we love to check on our Dutch test as well. And that's something that we do here in the office because this is obviously a very complex process. So most people, when they have their hormones tested, whether they're male or female, they literally will pull maybe 3 or 4 of these values. And you can see how complex this chart is. Does that seem like a good idea to accurately test your hormones? No. Absolutely not. So obviously we want a more detailed exam, a more detailed testing done to actually get a good snapshot of your hormones. So a lot of patients will come to me and they'll have progesterone tested, maybe testosterone, and like maybe E1, and that's it. And they think, oh, I've had a hormone test. I've had a hormone panel. Well, no, you guys, and this is even a simplified chart. So obviously there's a lot more complexity than this chart. So it's really, really important to understand that we've got this whole cascade that goes through both androgens, which are those male dominant hormones, and your female dominated hormones. The big one to understand as well is our stress hormone, cortisol. This comes through the progesterone section of your hormone cycle. So cortisol and cortisone, which is the inactive form, both of those are super inflammatory to the body. We don't want to have too much of that running around, and we definitely want to balance between the active form and the inactive form. So those people that haven't had like their adrenal, this is that stress hormone. It's produced in the adrenal glands for when it turns into the active form. And this is also part of that hormone pathway that gets produced throughout the body. So if people are like, oh, my adrenals are shot. Well, your cortisol is shot, but that could go further up and cause a lot of havoc on other hormones as well. And that, again, is why we test this guy on our Dutch test, and why it's really important to understand how all this cascade works. So I always tell patients it's like a giant fountain. So literally you can think about pregnenolone at the top, and that's how everything else starts to happen out and down. So when you start to have too much of something, too little of something, that's where I come in and we really assess what we need to do to get everything balanced back out. But then what makes us very special as Wellness Way practitioners is I go a step beyond that. So this is what makes us very different, and this is why we have such good clinical success, you guys. That's because I don't just look at this and say, oh, why is this patient's estrogen off? I sit there and say, okay, their estrogen is off. How did it get off in the first place? You know, I'm just not concerned about just bouncing back hormones. We want to know what triggered that in the first place. And that could be anything in the body. So you've got trauma, you've got toxins, you've got thoughts, plus you've got all these other systems that work with the other systems. So the hormonal system could be triggered by the immune system. The hormonal system can be triggered by the GI tract, by a gut issue, by an infection. It's just everything is connected to everything. So that's where I come in as that CSI detective to really get in there and say, okay, well, I've got estrogen, you know, estrone, for example, my E1 is off and it's crazy. Why did it get that way in the first place? So that's where, it makes us very, very different. So I want to talk to all my ladies out there, but my men as well. Things like cholesterol, we need to not be afraid of. We've become this fat-phobic society, you guys, where we're afraid to eat fat. And that is why we actually have infertility at an all-time high. We have all kinds of brain issues. I mean, cholesterol, you guys, is used throughout the entire body. It's not just involved in hormones. Every single little cell that you have throughout your body has a piece of fats that make up that cell membrane. So literally, fats are used in all of your different functions of your body. So it's especially important because this triggers a lot of hormone production. Hormones are generally very high in fats, so you obviously want to have a ton of that. But it's important for your everyday cell function. You know, if you cut yourself, or if you, you know, get a stomach virus, you know, you need cholesterol to rebuild and help those cells to turn over and to turn into new healthy cells again. So it's pretty cool, you guys, but hormones are all starting from healthy fat. And then I'm gonna do some more focused videos. I've done one already on progesterone, but coming up in the next few weeks, we'll do some more focused videos on kind of each of these pieces and why it's important to have it tested and how it can affect your fertility. So obviously the first piece of this is starting with just the building blocks, with the foundation. So are you getting enough healthy fats into your diet so you can make this stuff? That's really, really important to know. And have you had a big snapshot like this taken of your hormones? Because just having a few of these tested, you can see, really isn't going to help you know what's going on with your fertility issues. We got to get in there and do more of a big, nice snapshot of exactly what's going on. So, hope that helps you guys. We look forward to doing all our Fertility Fridays. We're going to keep them to 1 p.m. That way I have use of the TV and some of the cool stuff here in the office. Like I said, if you have a question, you have something else you'd like me to cover, just comment below and I will work it into what we're doing. So, Have a great weekend, you guys. I look forward to seeing you soon.